man sits as a judge and a woman is brought in front of him and charged with adultery, and the judge himself is the one with whom she committed adultery, but the judge stands up and berates the woman, in order to make no one even suspect that he is the real criminal who was involved with the woman, and humiliates her, and then sentences her into isolation, completely destroys her reputation, with no kind of protection for her or of her whatsoever. And she takes it. She loves him so much and believes so strongly in his sense of justice so much, she allows herself to be projected almost as a prostitute. And that man permits this, then that's not a man. To have gotten weak for a woman is one thing. It's human and it's natural. But after getting weak and completely destroying her reputation, to do nothing whatsoever to protect her as a woman, then he's not a man. And to
what's going on, fellas? It's another C Boogie. Y'all know the rest. Hey, I want to salute y'all for subscribing to my channel. And I also want to thank y'all for liking my videos. And shout out to the Dime Game Division. Let's rock and roll, man. I'm going to say this again. A lot of black men have penis problems in their life. You know, if you really break down what a lot of black men complain about, you know, and a lot of issues that we talk about, you know, maybe barbershop conversations, a lot of these problems started at the penis. You know, when guys talk about child support, baby mother drama, you know, certain kind of issues with their women, you know, STDs, outside children, outside of your marriage, you know, stuff like that. All of these are penis problems. And what happens is, for a lot of men, they go on this very dangerous journey of trying to cover up their fuckery, you know, their penis problems. And they take a lot of people down with them. When the reality is, the first place these guys should have looked was the mirror. You know what I mean? And that's really just a discipline issue. You know what I mean? A lot of black men have discipline issues with their penis. You know, first thing they do is blame the women. Oh, it was her fault. Oh, you know what I mean? She did this. She should have made me put on the condom. Stuff like that. You know, we all heard these things. You know, then guys blame the system. They blame society. You know, they blame the white man. But if you can trace back the majority of your issues in your life back to your penis, then the only place you can look at is the mirror. You see what I'm saying? And I find it very hypocritical from a lot of black men that have little to no sexual discipline and then turn around and say the same thing about these women. You know what I mean? Well, these women are hoes, they thots, they for the streets and all of that. But if you look at their life, you take a peek into their closet, everything says a lack of sexual discipline, you know. But you want to be the man. You want submission. You want people to follow you. You want a certain level of respect, you know, but your leadership style is do as I say, not as I do. And that's just something that I can't take it, man. You know what I'm saying? I don't get down with that. And the reason you see the thumbnail in the back with Malcolm X is because it's of my belief that one of the reasons, the biggest reason rather, that Malcolm X was murdered was because he exposed the extramarital affairs of his spiritual teacher, Elijah Muhammad. Now, Elijah Muhammad was the leader of the Nation of Islam before Farrakhan took over after he passed. And Elijah Muhammad, you know, he had a wife, Clara Muhammad, and they had 8 kids together. But Elijah Muhammad had 15 more children with 5 different women. You know, and some of these women were teenagers. One of the women even was his own niece, you know, the young girl, actually. And Malcolm X found out about it. First, he found out about it from Elijah Muhammad's son, you know, because he was very upset about it. And then he ended up talking to some of the women. Some of the women went to Malcolm because Elijah Muhammad not only Didn't he take care of the children? But he suspended the girls from the Nation of Islam. Now, when Malcolm X asked Elijah Muhammad about the situation, Elijah Muhammad looked at Malcolm X in his face and lied to him. And he broke his heart, you know. And this is something that we don't talk about a lot amongst black men, is that a lot of us do suffer from broken hearts because a lot of our heroes and leaders have let us down. You know, I've experienced this a lot, especially when I was in the military, man. I had a lot of platoon sergeants and sergeant majors and first sergeants that would get in front of the platoon or the company and tell us all of these things that we need to do, and kind of find out a lot of these guys were cheating on their wives, having outside children, you know, domestic violence investigations, you know. And you end up kind of losing some respect for these dudes. You know, it's not about judging guys, but damn, how as a first sergeant you gonna call me into your office and take my rank off my chest because I made a mistake, but look how you live in your life. You gotta ask yourself, did you set the example properly? Where you think I'm learning this behavior from? I'm learning it from you. It may not be directly, it's happening subconsciously, but I'm learning these behaviors from you. You see what I'm saying? And a lot of people don't understand how that works. A lot of black men suffer from a broken heart because we have been let down. Just imagine, you know, for the people that grew up with a mother and father in the home, just imagine if you caught your father cheating on your mother, or hell, even your mother cheating on your father, like you physically seen it. And let's say you was a kid. Imagine what that would do to your psyche. You know what I mean? Growing up, man, my uncle was my hero. You know what I mean? My uncle was a military guy. He was a career soldier. Every time I seen him, he was doing man stuff. He took care of his family. He probably was the best man that was in my family. He was the most dependable, the most responsible. But he could not stop cheating on his wife. You know, he had about 5 outside kids. Just all kind of stuff, man. And he really hurt his kids and destroyed his kids. Penis problems, you know. And now he has a very strange relationship with his children. But it wasn't always like that, you know. And he had daughters, and those girls loved him to death. But you know what happened? My uncle kept hurting that mother over and over again till eventually they turned on him, you know. So who can my uncle blame? Can't blame society. Gotta blame your penis, man. You know what I mean? Real talk. Real talk, man. So Elijah Muhammad lied to Malcolm X's face, and that really crushed him, dog. That hurt that man to his core, to the point where he ended up just leaving the Nation of Islam. Well, the Nation of Islam put him out, and he just stayed out until his death, you know. And then to this day, the Nation of Islam covers up Elijah Muhammad's, for lack of better words, fuckery with these women. No, they were not his wives. They were his concubines. Some of these women were teenagers. One of the girls was his own niece. You know, no, they wasn't his wives. But they cover it up to this day. And I honestly feel like the Nation of Islam will never rise to its full potential until they make that right with Malcolm X, until they fix that. How do you fix it? Well, you got to put out the truth, man. You got to put out the truth. The truth may set you free. We heard it a million times, you know. And then you heal from the situation. And then you move on. But Malcolm X was ultimately killed. But if you trace that line back, he was ultimately killed because of Elijah Muhammad's penis problems that he had. Point blank, period. So you see how deep these things can go? A lot of people don't really understand that. And this is what you really see with a lot of black men. Truth be told, I just gotta say it, man. A lot of our penis problems go so deep. And the lack of accountability that a lot of us have, we'll do anything to cover it up. will hurt people in the process, destroy families, you know. And it's crazy, man. It all starts with discipline. It all starts with self-awareness. It all starts with honesty, man. And I don't hear enough of these conversations happening. You know, I barely hear them at all. And anytime you try to have these real, honest, in-depth conversations, oh, you a simp. Oh, you not for the brotherhood. Oh, you this. Oh, you that. Well, Malcolm X had the same issues. And ultimately, it cost him his life. Even though we celebrate Malcolm X to this day, he lost his life because of honor. He lost his life because he chose to do the right thing. He lost his life because he was an honest man. And he was honest with himself. You know, he was honest with himself. And this is what I want a lot of brothers to really think about, man. How far do your penis problems go? You know what I mean? And do you take accountability for them? Not about being perfect. I don't expect anybody to be perfect, but I'm gonna close with this. And I really want y'all to think about this. Don't y'all find it very hypocritical that in this society, in the United States of America, black men ask for a lot, you know, from society, mainstream society. We want to sit at the table. We want it to be treated equal. For a lot of us, we want second chances and third chances. You know, people that have been in prison and they may have a record that they got when they was young. We want that expunged. And, you know, we want people to see us for our character and not our circumstances. Don't judge us from our past and our background. We want a lot. So ultimately, black men, we ask in society for compassion. But do we give these women compassion when they make a mistake? In most cases, the same mistake that the man has made. They've dabbled in the same activities that the man has done. Or is it off with their head? They don't deserve a second chance. She's this, she's that. She's nothing. Feed her to the wolves, send her to the streets. But then black men turn around and ask for that very same thing from society. And you know the truth? This is why society will never give us that. Because we don't give it to each other. Point blank, period. And that's the truth as I see it. Shout out to the Dime Game Division. Peace.